There's a narrative out there that millennials and the Generation Z's behind them are lazy.
What do you think of millennials? Coddled, entitled?
Yes, I think so.
Millennials don't get off the couch very often.
Millennials don't want jobs.
Well, that is just bunk. The reason a lot of young people are not doing nearly as well as their parents at this stage is that they're paying huge amounts, much more than their parents ever paid as a proportion of their paychecks, for education, higher education, or student debt, housing, for rent, healthcare, even transportation. All of these costs have increased faster than inflation. And at the same time, jobs are not paying that much more. We know that 1 in 10 college graduates are underemployed. And by underemployed, we mean that they are not spending 40 hours a week doing things that are challenging and taking advantage of their education. 1 out of 20 are unemployed. In the post-World War II era, we have never seen anything like this. That is, we have always expected that we're going to do better. Individuals and families are going to do better. They're going to be trading upward, and their children are expected to do better than they have done. And that's been the case. For the first time now, we see the pendulum moving in exactly the opposite direction. Today, more than ever before, your chance of getting ahead as a young person is dependent on the parents you have and their income and their wealth. We are on the verge of the largest intergenerational wealth transfer in history. We've got 74 million baby boomers. They've never done so well. I mean, they are raking it in. With all of the problems and challenges that young people are facing, you've got this extra resource that is going to be going to those small slice of millennials and Generation Zs who have wealthy parents and grandparents. If nothing changes, the two-tiered society we have right now is going to become even wider in terms of the gap between the haves and the have-nots. One of the most important things is to make college free. The other thing we need to do is make healthcare cheaper. We've got to have a single-payer plan. We also can do a much better job with regard to affordable housing. I just want to give information and analysis that's useful, and I want to inspire action and change, because we can't go on the way we are going right now.